Anderson Cooper, AC 360, CNN Weeknights 10 Eastern.
Well, I want to break down exactly what this is. It's a type of bacteria. It's common in the environment, and it can be on different types of food. This strain specifically, Salmonella enteritidis, is found in chickens. They can carry the bug or even pass it on to their eggs without getting sick themselves. They can be sort of carriers. Now, if you get salmonella through contaminated eggs or meat, the bacteria goes to the lining of the small intestine. Symptoms can be mild or severe, but mainly it's going to be GI or gastrointestinal symptoms, cramps, nausea, diarrhea, vomiting. It can also cause fever, can cause severe headache. One possible long-term complication, it can get into the joints and cause arthritis, and that can linger for months or even longer. Mild or severe, most people are going to recover fully, but complications can be serious. Older people, young babies, and people with immune problems are going to be most at risk. In the worst case, the bacteria can get into the bloodstream and cause a severe infection called sepsis. That's life-threatening, although with treatment, the fatality rate is still pretty low, about less than a tenth of a percent. Salmonella makes about 1.3 million people sick every year. That's according to the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention. It's neck and neck with Campylobacter, another bacteria, the second most common foodborne illness. The most common by far is norovirus. That makes about 9 million people sick every year. Big numbers. By contrast, E. coli only makes about 40,000 people sick, and botulism, we talk about that a lot, only causes about 50 or 60 cases total every year. Of course, those tend to be more severe, sometimes even deadly.